As the months passed, and it became clear that the RCMP had no leads in Lisa's case, the community and Lisa's family pushed for a Crime Stoppers reenactment video to be produced. But the Nanaimo detachment spokesman stated that Crime Stoppers was not making videos anymore. This was a blatant lie. Crime Stoppers never stopped making videos, all that was needed was for an investigator to submit basic information about Lisa's case. Despite this revelation, it still took several more years for that email to get sent. In 2009, the video was released. However, most of the information the RCMP provided to Crime Stoppers was wrong. The video says Lisa attended various nightclubs that night, but in reality, the jungle was the only one. It also says she left the bar at 2:30 a.m., half an hour after the bar closed, and that was when she was first approached by the man with the jaguar. In reality, the conversation occurred as she was arriving at the bar, around midnight. They left the bar around 1 a.m., an hour before close. The video says five people gladly accepted the invitation to the party. The fact is, only Lisa and Dallas went with the man, and Lisa didn't want to go, but felt pressured and obligated. The video states the second house party was in Westwood Lake area, while it's widely known that it was actually in Cather's Lake area. The video also claims Lisa became hungry at 2 a.m., but in actuality, the driver had offered to buy food for the group if Lisa would help him go get it. The video says, this was the last time anyone ever saw Lisa, yet fails to mention Lisa's ominous phone call an hour later. They won't bring me back. And, obviously, someone saw Lisa after leaving the second party. Most notably, the man driving the car. The video also claims that Lisa's family waited several days before contacting police. Lisa's mother actually called it in within hours of Lisa's final phone call. But it was in fact the RCMP who initially delayed the investigation by 10 days before admitting that something may have gone wrong. There's even a contradiction between dates, near the end of the video. Each of these errors are minor on their own, but when combined, they make up more than half the information presented in the video. This is representative of the level of care the RCMP's put into the investigation all along. Let's take a look at one more, official, source of misinformation. And after that, you will learn the truth about what really happened that night.